You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download. And we're back to continue our hand roto. Let's turn off the overlays. I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut A and then A again to toggle through the different states of the alpha overlay. I'll keep my forearm turned on, but I will lock it. Now, normally I'd come in and start working on the hand, you know, work upwards along here. But with roto in the hand, I'm going to probably be using the same techniques I did for the arm. So I want to show you instead how we're going to work on one of the fingers. And I think we'll do the index finger. There we go. And let's take a look at this. Okay. And let's take a look at this stabilized out using the planar tracking data. Oh, actually, while I'm here, I'll show you how this looks using the Mocha tracking data to stabilize out the viewer. This is really interesting to me because we're using one layer to stabilize out the viewer, but the main arm roto is being locked down by the other tracking data, the planar tracking data. So we can mix and match. And, you know, just to show you what's going on here, I'm going to do that in this section. Okay, so let's take a look at the finger movement itself. There's a little bit more sort of roll happening with the fingers here. It's not so much the big movements that we saw with the arm. It's actually sort of smaller movements going on. And I want to show you something we can do with some of the other reshape tools. You'll see that the reshape tool itself has a tiny little arrow at the bottom right-hand corner. This means that if I press and hold this, we have other tool options available to us. And we have things like the magnetic reshape tool. So this is kind of interesting. If I select all of my points here and I start moving points around with the magnetic reshape tool, instead of all the points moving at the same amount in the same direction, what's happening here with the magnetic reshape tool is the point where we are clicking and selecting is going to be moving as it would do with the regular reshape tool. But the further the points are away from that initial click from the cursor, the less they're going to be affected by our movement. And this is exceedingly handy for this kind of organic shape where we have certain areas of the shape moving at different paces. Say even here, just add a keyframe there. Add another little keyframe there. We've got very, very small amount of movement in the fingers, but the movement isn't uniform. Like the tip is usually anchored down. This tool is also very good when we're doing hair as well to help us just to do that sort of movement. And we obviously don't have to have all of the points selected. I could just select a number of the control points. And it's going to work in the same way. Let's just undo that. Now, the only disadvantage we have with the magnetic tool is we have to manually select the points that we want to affect. One of the really nice things about Silhouette is it tries to limit the amount of clicking we're going to be doing for these types of regular tasks, which brings me to the third of my reshape tools, which is the brush reshape. Now, the brush reshape, instead of giving me just a pointer, gives me a full brush, and I can change the size of this just like I could a regular paintbrush in the paint node. So if I hold down the control or command key on Mac and scrub left and right, I can make this bigger or smaller. And as I drag this over the shape, you can see that this works by selecting a number of points that are covered by the brush. And if I click and move on this, we get that same sort of movement as we did with the magnetic reshape tool. Now, we can change the behavior of this to make it so the brush reshape tool just acts like a regular reshape tool by holding down the shift key when we make a change. That just moves everything together. But most of the time, you're just going to be clicking and dragging. And let's see how that's going to work over the next few frames. So here I want a shape that's quite big or very big, and I can just come in here and then just move that, slot that into place. Again, always looking for those points of maximum drift. When I need to, just come in with a smaller brush using the control key. Just just to reshape that. It's very small amounts a lot of the time that we're changing. And it's those ones that really make the difference. So by doing it this way, we're kind of shortcutting the big to small, because we have really no big movements in there. We just have small to small movements, but we want to make those changes as smooth as possible. So not adding in keyframes where we don't need them, and making sure that we're doing point to point matching on our shapes as well, so we get nice smooth animation between them. Right, I'll be back again when I've finished up the rest of the finger. And here we are with the fruits of our labor. So again, let's do the overlay. Coming up and turning off the stabilization. I'll turn off the outlines as well up here. And just check to see how our roto shape's doing. And that's, you know, looking pretty good. And it looks like we're missing a little bit of the finger here, but actually, once we add in a little bit of motion blur onto that and turn motion blur on the node itself, that's going to start to work itself out anyway. Remembering, of course, that we are going to be adding a little bit of blur to this at a later date. So I think that's going to be just fine. All I'm going to do now is do exactly what I've done in the last two exercises, except I'm going to do it on the other fingers and on the hand. So on the main back of the hand, I'm probably going to be using the same techniques as I did with the forearm and the fingers. I'm just going to be using the reshape tool as we've just done here. I'll be back in the next part with a fully rotoed hand, and we can take it from there. See you in just a bit.